Welcome to CountryLifeProjects.com. I'm Henry Reinders. This is video 12 of 15 videos in our shed project. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to finish off your LP smart side panels on the side of your shed. It's not very complicated, but there are some key things you need to know. So let's get started with those now. We have finished all our trim, all our soffit material. We have our smart side panels on the front of the shed and the back of the shed. The blocking has all been removed all the way around the perimeter of the roof, and at this point you can go ahead and do your roof, or as we're going to do, we're going to finish our smart side panels first. The weather's pretty good, so we're not too worried about rain. However, if you are concerned about the weather, either tarp off the roof or do the roof first. As long as you have your bracing still on the inside of your shed, you'll be fine. But we're going to go ahead and start these. There's not really too much to it on this side here. I want to make a note that the piece that we cut off at the end is going to be used on the other side, and we're going to be starting the other side differently. Here though, they're with these panels, they are 48 5/8 inches wide. So when you go to center them, it's going to seem kind of strange because the panel will actually come to this edge here. So I just want to show you that. Okay, to make sure your smart side panels are centered properly, this line here is the part that's exposed. That needs to be centered on your stud. Really how that works out is that this edge here is almost on the outside of this stud. You're pretty close there. And at the other side of the front corner, if you look here, you'll see that this edge here, which is our lap edge, is flush with our other panel on the inside. So it's right at the edge of our 2x4 wall. That's how your panel should be positioned. And we're going to go ahead and nail it in place. The same way that we did the front panels, we're going to glue them. The material is not that thick, it's not that strong, so you need the glue for the rigidness and stability of your shed and to make sure that it stays square. So we're going to go ahead and put about a 1/4 inch bead on all our studs, top plate and bottom plate. This one here, you don't have to worry about the glue being to one side or the other. This is our joint stud because the panel covers pretty much all of the stud. I'm going to put a bead on the lower top plate and carry on down right down to our joist header on the bottom. That helps tie the walls to the base. Got that done. Now you'll notice there's a bit of a curve on our panel here. That can be a little bit problematic when you're trying to set your panel on our base blocks here. And so I'm going to show you something. If you do have warp panels, gently bring it over into place. Try not to smudge the glue. Just put it on the ground. Bring it over. Get it on your blocks. Now here you can see on the bottom, the panel wants to pop out. So just temporarily, once you have it approximately in place, just take a couple blocks. These are the leftover ones we used on the roof. Screw those on there, and the panel will not pop out anymore. Using short blocks leaves you room to nail as well. So now we're going to bring our panel over. Just double check everything is fine. Okay, we're in position here. using 2-inch galvanized finishing nails. We're going to start at the bottom. You don't have to worry about denting the wood here. We're going to have trim on there after. Work your way up the panel. Now on this edge here, you want to be in about an inch, inch and a half, so you're not nailing through the overlap flange here, but you're nailing into the solid material. And here, our studs are 16 on center, our grooves are 16 on center, so we know we can just use those as a guide. Set these after. And your nail spacing should be about 12 to 16 inches. With the glue, 16 is probably fine. You'll notice that I just nailed that completely on because I'm nailing through the flange, which gets covered later. And just keep going right till the top, get it all secured. Make sure the top's nice and tight. It can be a little tricky nailing up here. Just nail into the studs. If you have to, you can screw the top in. Let's keep it about 3/4 of an inch from the top of the panel, because otherwise the trim won't cover it. So I'm gonna finish securing that. I'll show you how to do the next panel, and we'll continue from there. Our panel's in place. It's pretty much nailed off. We always start from the bottom because we have our blocks as a guide that we installed earlier. But as you get to the top, if your panel is warped, it's difficult enough to be nailing in this area up here as it is. And if there's a bit of a wow here, chances are your nails are going to pop or you're not going to be able to nail it on properly. So what I do in this situation is I just screw up no more than 3/4 of an inch down, go up on an angle because you want to nail into that top, or screw into the top plate. And since we're in the groove, later on when we put our trim on here, it won't interfere with the trim, it'll sit nicely on the panels. I would recommend doing one in every groove. This needs to be fairly flat so that your trim sits on here quite nicely when we're doing the final stages of the shed. So that's about it for getting that secured up top. There's one more thing I'll be showing you, and that's how we're going to put our glue on here and do the next panel. So I'm going to finish screwing this off now. We start our second panel. This is already glued in behind here. We're going to have to put a bead of glue on top of here as well to make sure that the panels are all binding together. And it helps to ensure that when this is the lap joint here, that it doesn't lift later on. The other thing, they didn't outline this clearly enough on the first sheet, is these panels come up 3/4 of an inch onto the first top plate here. So your glue, you want to have on the lower part of this plate. So we're going to do that. We're going to finish up all these panels. When you do your last panel, cut it about 1/4 inch back from the end. so that you're not protruding, because that'll interfere with your trim when we get to the final stages of the shed. So I'm going to finish this off now, get this joint glued up, get the rest of it glued up, and finish up this side. Okay, we finished our last piece. You'll see that we're flush with the end of the wall, 2x4 here. Now the piece that came off, which is this piece here, is what we're going to start the other side with. And we're going to start from this end of the shed forward with this lip here being the first on the first joist here on the other side. So we'll go to do that next. But for this side here, we're all done. Okay, we finished our smart side panels on the other side. We're going to do this side now. Now our spacing, 16-inch centers, is on both sides is 16 inches front to back. And on the other side, our last piece, we have a 27-inch piece left over, which is what we're going to use here. Now you do want to start at this end, because the lip here is what's going to be overlapped by the next piece. So this has to be your starting strip. Now the piece that came off the other side is perfect. It's 27 inches wide. We got lots of material. But I do want to show you for measuring, our center of our stud is here. The center of our groove that's going to be showing is here. And you'll see that the edge of the panel here is flush with the stud. So all you have to do, just measure from this side of the stud to the outside of this 2x4. We have 21 3/4. I'm going to go ahead and cut that. Remember, when you're measuring it, you're measuring now from there, not the center of your groove. I'm going to get that cut. We're going to go ahead and finish installing all our smart panels on this side. Exactly the same procedure as the other side. Once we're done with that, we're going to get the shed painted. Okay, we finished our smart side panels. We have 2 coats of finish paint on them. At this point here, you may decide that you want to go ahead and finish the roof, or you may want to finish the trim first and then do the roof. If you're going to go trim first, you'll need to put the door in. We have a video for that, and then you could watch our video on installing the trim. We're going to do the roof next. The weather's a little bit iffy, so we want to get that on there. So that'll be our next video. But if you're at this point, it's up to you which one you want to watch. All of them are available. And we'll see you in the roofing video.